blood flow restriction. So this is also called KOTSU, BFR. And I don't know if you know what BFR is, Vishen, but I can give a, I know this is recorded on Spotify, but we're on video at the moment, and I can show you, like, it's a cuff that goes around, for example, your bicep, and it holds at about 7 or 8 in tightness. So you're cutting off venous blood flow, but you're not cutting off arterial blood flow. So it's tight, but it's not too tight. And what happens is you get cell swelling. This is so cool because it's like doing 4 sets of 10 reps a couple reps in. So you're just forwarding yourself to what would be the super pump, and I can't take any more, and the lactic acid, oh, it's killing me. Like, you're getting there right away with this blood flow restriction. And when you add things like drop sets, supersets to it, you're getting a lot of fatigue on the muscle, and you can cut your workouts literally down to like 10 or 15 minutes. There's one more that I really like to do called intra-set stretching.
Wait, just before you go off KOTSU. Okay, so I've been hearing about KOTSU. In fact, I was just hanging out with Ben Greenfield, and he brought up KOTSU. He mentioned, hey, you got to look into KOTSU. And so it's so nice to have you mention KOTSU again. So let's say we have a regular workout that we really like, right? Let's say it's 20 or 30 or 40 minutes, and we use a concept like KOTSU. What, if you had to estimate, what percentage efficiency would that workout go up?
Massive, like literally, like 50%. It's literally, it's
Really?
so massive because
50%?
look,
Wow.
it's all about getting to this point. There's actually a Z line that's in the muscle that has to do with eccentric movements, and there's also sensors in the muscle for how much cell swelling there is. And it's like, this is like just fast forwarding your workout to that 10th rep on the fourth set, like when your muscle's so overpumped, it's so swollen, you can barely continue. But if I get one more rep in, that's the one that's going to make the difference. It's the last rep of your set, and it's certainly the last rep of your last set, if that makes sense. That's where the
That's the
muscle's
one that's going to
most
make the
fatigued.
difference. Right.
And that's where time under tension comes in too. And if you can keep a movement more controlled and more under tension instead of bouncing at the bottom, bouncing at the top, then that's good. But there's a new idea that's also called intra-set stretching. So in between, let's say you're doing that set of curls, in between sets, when you're resting for 30 seconds, let's say, you flex your triceps as hard as you possibly can. And at this point, the bicep is fully stretched. Okay. And you've just been doing curls. And so the biceps have been working, working, working. And now you're fully stretching the bicep by flexing the tricep. And then you go right back into your next set. So the bicep is always being fatigued. And it's just an exhaustive exercise. So you add blood flow restriction, intra-set stretching, drop
I
sets
see.
all into the same exercise. And in 10 minutes, you're going
That's
to
fascinating.
vent.
Now,